This is the brand new M-Audio Oxygen Pro Mini Keyboard. This is the Akai MPK Mini Mark III. Today I'm gonna show you why the Oxygen Pro is the one most of you should buy. Most of you. Because, well, there are a few things about the MPK Mini that some of you may really love. Now, first of all, this is not a sponsored video, and if you didn't know, M-Audio and Akai brands are both owned by the same parent company, so they're kind of competing, but not too much. But they are so different, and they're the same price. All right, let's get into a side-by-side comparison of features. This is gonna be fun. And if you're interested in checking out my full review of the Akai MPK Mini Mark III, you can watch it here. I'll leave links to purchase either of these keyboards in the video description below. If you're new around here, I'm Sanjay C. I have tons of videos about music production and the latest music gear on my channel. Consider subscribing if you haven't already. I always get straight to the good stuff in all my videos. Let's get started. First up, keybed. The Oxygen Pro Mini has 32 keys, 7 more keys than the MPK Mini. And the Oxygen keys feel better in my opinion. The Oxygen Pro has a much lighter feel and you have to be very gentle if you want to play softly. The Akai is on the other end of the spectrum. You have to really bang on it to play louder. You can configure the key sensitivity easily on the Oxygen Pro Mini. I still haven't figured out how to do it on the MPK Mini. If you know how, please comment below. So the winner for the keybed, Oxygen Pro Mini. Next, the Oxygen Pro Mini has pitch and mod wheels, much easier to control than the MPK Mini's joystick. Yes, the joystick saves space, but it's all too easy to be moving both pitch and mod when you're just trying to move one. Winner? Oxygen Pro. Next, let's talk about the pads. Like key feel, pad feel is subjective. I've always liked Akai's pads on MPK keyboards, and I do prefer these over the Oxygen Pro Mini. They seem to have better sensitivity, the right amount of stiffness, and they're just larger. But the Oxygen Pro pads are fine, actually more than fine. I'm gonna give this one to Akai. Hey, by the way, M-Audio makes bigger, full-size key versions of the Oxygen Pro line, and you can watch my full review of the 25 key version right here. I've also got a full review of the Hammer Action 88 key version of this too. Don't miss that. And if you already own one of these keyboards, let me know what made you choose them in the comments below. Next, let's talk about DAW control. There are several aspects of DAW control, so let's take them one by one. First is DAW compatibility. The Oxygen Pro Mini offers built-in DAW configuration for all the popular DAWs, including Ableton Live, Pro Tools, Bitwig, Studio One, Cubase, Logic, Reaper, FL Studio, and Reason. The MPK Mini has configurations for GarageBand, Ableton Live, FL Studio, and Logic. But here's the kicker, even though the MPK has settings for different DAWs, I couldn't get the controls to do much at all. And you know why? Because there's not much here. The MPK Mini really just has these knobs to control your DAW. The Oxygen Pro has play, stop, record, faders to control your mixer volumes, loop on or off, forward, rewind. This is a DAW controller, and the MPK Mini is not. If you use Ableton, yes, the MPK Mini's knobs do control devices, but the Oxygen Pro gives you that, and you can trigger clips and scenes. You can't do that on the MPK Mini. Now, when it comes to knobs, Akai is the winner. It has 8 instead of 4 on the Oxygen. Well, the Oxygen has 4 faders as well. I'll get to that in a bit. The Akai knobs are also endless, which is really nice, and most people prefer that. The Oxygen knobs are not. Hey, if you're looking for some great samples and chord progressions to inspire your next song or beat, check out my sample packs and even my Rhodes virtual instrument. The Friday Night sample pack has some hard-hitting drum loops for trap and hip-hop and pop. Aurora has both MIDI chord progressions, so you can apply any instrument you want to it. Sanjay's Rhodes is a virtual instrument that works with Kontakt and the free Sforzando player. It's sampled directly from my 1975 Fender Rhodes Mark I stage piano. know. Link is in the description. Don't forget to check out the freebies on my site as well. Thank you for supporting my channel. And don't forget that every year I take 10% of the earnings from all my sales of the sound packs and the virtual instrument and donate it to a good cause. Okay, let's address the faders on the Oxygen Pro. M-Audio chose to reduce the number of knobs in favor of faders instead. The faders are great. These are the better way to control mixer volume because you can control multiple tracks at once with one hand. You can't do that with knobs. The faders are fine, but I found that they didn't work that well in Logic. I love the faders, so I'm gonna give this win to the Oxygen Pro again. So you might be saying, Sanjay, that's all great, but the MPK Mini has that note repeat button and they've got some arpeggiator features now too. Yes, and so does the Oxygen Pro Mini. Note repeat, arpeggiator options, pretty much the same as you get with the MPK Mini. And even chord and scale features are on the Oxygen Pro. It's great if you're not up to speed on music theory yet. Winner, Oxygen Pro. Okay, how about connecting external gear like a synth? Let's check the back. Well, they both got the USB port and a sustain port, but hey, the Oxygen Pro has a MIDI port as well. So yeah, connect a synth to this and you're good. Winner, Oxygen Pro. All right, I've got to give one other win to the MPK Mini Mark III. Size. It's small and light. If you need something really portable, this is easier to carry around, but the Oxygen Pro Mini isn't that much bigger. And honestly, I think the Oxygen Pro looks so much better. The MPK Mini just looks and feels like a toy. The Oxygen Pro feels, well, pro. But still, size-wise, we'll give the win to Akai. Listen, both of these keyboards have decent features, and depending on what you need, choose the one that suits you. I just feel that for the features missing on the Akai MPK Mini Mark III, they really should be charging a lot less. Now, there are some things I couldn't test. First, the test of time. These are both fairly new keyboards, so I don't know how well they'll last long term. Also, I couldn't test every feature in every DAW, so do your research on DAW compatibility, especially if there's a feature you really need. Lastly, everyone is different, so a keyboard I prefer may not be the right one for you, but I hope you got a little value from this video. Hey, if you want to support my channel, consider checking out my merch. You can get this shirt I'm wearing or a bunch of other things like sweatshirts and hoodies in different styles, even iPhone cases and home accessories. Thanks for your support. And if you want to keep learning more about music production and the latest gear, check the links below and the videos right here. Keep making the music you love, and I'll see you later.